Hello everyone, I hope you have been preparing well for your IFSCA Grade A exam. In this session, we'll be discussing MCQs related to the GIFT IFSCA, and this is part 7. We have been continuing the discussion on the same. MCQs related to this part have been discussed in 6 more sessions in the previous series, right? So, we have discussed a few MCQs on Global Financial Centers and the Act has been discussed. These are part of, these topics are actually part of the phase 2 paper 2 of IFSCA Grade A exam, as you can see, and these are slightly unconventional. And so to help you out with the same, we have come up with this series. Here is the question that was asked in the previous session. Which among the following financial center is one of the 15 centers that have a reputational disadvantage as per the Global Financial Centers Index 2022? So as we have discussed previously also, 2022 index is the latest one that talks about these global financial centers, and in that you should be knowing the top 5 which have been performing well in overall and in various fields, and also you should be knowing what has been the performance of the Indian centers. Right, so there is this list that talks about the reputational disadvantage that certain centers have. Even though they perform well, their reputation due to various factors is not good, because of it their perception has been less, and that is also indirectly affecting their performance. So which are these centers? There is a list of 15 such centers. Are these centers part of it? Is New Delhi part of it? Mumbai or GIFT Gujarat? GIFT City Gujarat, are they part of that list? This is the question here. Options you can see 1 only, 3 only, 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 1, 2 and 3. So here only New Delhi is part of it. Okay, it has a reputational disadvantage in this list, that even though it performs well, the reputation is not so good due to various factors, right? So our concern here is yes, New Delhi is part of it, but Mumbai and GIFT City Gujarat are not part of it. And you can see the listing here, there are various other centers, Helsinki, Buenos Aires, we have Wuhan, Beijing, obviously reputationally for other things also, they have a disadvantage, Glasgow, Athens, and all of these. And we see New Delhi here, right? So that also has a reputational disadvantage. So A is the right answer. Moving on to the first question of our session. Which among the following statement is or are correct with respect to GIFT City? Right? GIFT City is connected with a fault tolerant optical fiber ring infrastructure. Right? So we have a ring infrastructure of the network there. Is it fault tolerant and is it using optical fiber? Obviously it will be, but is it fault tolerant? The GIFT City has no waste visibility. Water is drinkable from any tap. Are these facilities available in the GIFT City as far as the infrastructural, from the infrastructural point of view? Yes. So the first thing here, that it is fault tolerant, that is if at all there is any fault, that is not going to affect the entire network. That unit, that part where the fault is there, that can be corrected and the entire network is not going to be affected. That is what a fault tolerant optical fiber network is all about. So the first statement here is correct. GIFT City has no waste visibility, yeah, and water is drinkable from any tap. That is also correct, right? So all the three are correct. Our answer here is E, and the description with the same respect to same you can see here. We have discussed various parts of these in the previous sessions also. Yes, so moving on to the second question. Which among the following statement is or are correct with respect to units that are operating in the IFSC GIFT City Gujarat? The first statement says international exchanges operational from this zone are mandated to run 24 hours a day. Okay, they have to be running 24 hours a day. Is that mandated? IFSC units can open foreign currency current account with the banks operating in the GIFT IFSC. Again, here it is asked that whether the IFSC units here, they can open foreign currency current account. So this statement we have discussed previously also. And is it correct? Investment advisors are part of the capital market ecosystem established in GIFT IFSC. Okay, so this is also again asked. Are investment advisors part of the capital market ecosystem in IFSC? Okay, so the first statement here says international exchanges operational from this zone are mandated to run 24 hours a day. Firstly, the timing is not 24 hours, it is 22 hours. And also the word mandated is not correct. They're not mandated to function even for 22 hours. They do run for 22 hours is the information that is given on the website. So you need to be very careful careful with the wordings given in the statement. Even if you don't know that it is 22 hours, you should be knowing that whether it is mandated or not. It is not mandated. So the first statement is not correct. As soon as we strike that out, we are left out with the rest. Gift, the IFSC units can open foreign currency current accounts. We know that they can open foreign currency current account, and foreign currency is something that is to be used within the IFSCs. And which section of IFSCA Act actually talks about foreign currency, you need to tell me in the comment section. Please be really clear that you need to keep revising these things as you are preparing, and that is going to help you out in your exam for sure, right? So you need to tell me which section of IFSC Act actually talks about this foreign currency and transactions related to the same. The statement here is correct. Investment advisors are part of the capital market ecosystem. That is also correct. So it is not two only, not three only. It is two and three only. That is D. So you can see the explanation to the same here. Moving on to the third question. The number of international bullion exchanges present in the GIFT IFSC is or are, right? At present, although there can be more later on, for now, what is the number of these international bullion exchanges? Okay, so bullion is a very important part of your syllabus as far as the phase 2 exam is concerned. And here, the international bullion exchange, how many of them are present in the GIFT IFSC? That is being asked. Is it 1, 2, 3, 5 or 6? So the correct answer here is 1. There is only one international bullion exchange that we have within the GIFT IFSC. That is called India International Bullion Exchange IFSC Limited. Right? Do remember this. Moving on to fourth question. Really? Good question here. The International Financial Services Centers Authority, preparation and presentation of financial statements and International Financial Service Center Insurance Office Regulation 2022. Don't get afraid by looking at the question. Read what the question exactly is asking you. Have been made by the IFSCA as per the powers conferred on it by dash section of the IFSCA Act. So this is a regulation that has been made by the IFSCA. So regulations are made as powers conferred on the IFSCA by which of these sections? That is the question here. Okay, so always read the question properly. It might, the question is not directly related to this regulation, but it asks that regulation, this particular regulation has been made by the powers conferred on IFSCA by which of the sections of IFSCA Act. So please do read the question in the exam. Even though you don't know about the regulation, you know that regulations are made under the powers granted, powers provided to IFSCA as part of Section 28 of the Act. Right, so that is something that we know, and if you open the document of the regulation, you'll find it at the top, right, how Section 28 is actually the part of the IFSC Act which gives this powers. What about Section 14, 24, 2 and 34? You need to keep revising. That is what I have been telling you. Section 14 actually talks about central government grants that are given to the IFSCA. Section 24 talks about these members of the IFSCA and the officers being called public servant for the sake of various immunities, etc., that they have been provided with. Section 2 actually talks about the application of this specific act. 34 talks about the savings, and it talks about the period of application, etc. Right? So we have these, and you should keep revising this. And 28 is actually the section that talks about the regulations, the power of making regulations that IFSCAs have. Moving on, this is the fifth question, which is homework for you. Which among the following agencies of Government of India is mandated to carry out the security audit of the website of IFSCA as per regulations of the authority? Is it National Cybercrime Reporting Agency, Information Security Agency, Investigation Agency, Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, or is it National Counterterrorism Center? Okay, so out of these, which is the body that is mandated to carry out the security audit of the website which you have been viewing for your preparation, of that IFSCA website, which of these are actually mandated to do the security audit, cyber audit? Okay, so that should be really clear, right? You should be able to answer this question really fast. and please do answer this in the comment section. And to help you out with your preparation, we have come up with this ultimate test series, which actually has the tests related to phase 1 paper 1, phase 1 paper 2, phase 2 paper 1, and phase 2 paper 2. Each and every component has been covered through MCQs, and you can cover your entire syllabus, the preparation of entire syllabus, and also check your preparation by attempting these. There are also full and test 10 for phase 1 and 10 for phase 2. You can avail this test series by clicking on the link in the description. If you have any doubts with respect to your preparation, you can call us on 8146207241 or drop a mail at hello@adutab.co.in. And don't forget to drop a mail if these sessions are also helping you out with your preparation, so that keeps us motivated. Also, you can drop your feedback in the comments section. Thank you so much. Keep your confidence high. All the best for the upcoming exam.